गया था, तुमसे भेंट करने के लिए गया, तो पहले बार वो स्वस्थ थे, उन्होंने आशीर्वाद दिया हमको और बड़ा आदर किया और पूछा ये फिर कोई ग्रंथ लिखा है, ये पूछते थे जो। और दूसरी बार अभी गया तो बोल नहीं सके, केवल आंख थोड़ी सी खोल दिया, बस बोल नहीं सके, विवश थे, बोल नहीं सके। किंतु मैं समझता हूं जो आशीर्वाद अभी बताया गया 102 वर्ष की आयु थी, उनको कुछ पहले ही जाना चाहिए था, उनको बार बार बुला रहे थे लोग, किंतु कुछ लोगों ने जबरदस्ती उनके साथ में की और जबरदस्ती मैं समझता हूं उन्होंने ठीक उचित कार्य नहीं किया। मैं अपने विचार से कहता हूं जबरदस्ती किसी को रखने में वो लोग नहीं समझते हैं। जब कोई राधा कृष्ण के पास में जा रहा हो और हम उसको रोक दें तो क्या होगा, नहीं जाने दें, अपने स्वार्थ से उनको कितना कष्ट हो रहा है। और भी इसमें सब विचार है, तो जैसे भी हो वो परम पूज्य का हमारे भक्ति प्रमोद पूरी गोस्वामी महाराज हम सब पर वो लोग मरते नहीं, कोई भी जीवात्मा नहीं मरती है तो वैष्णव की तो बात क्या, भागवत लोग नहीं मरते हैं, इसलिए जहां भी हम लोगों पर कृपा करें, जब उनके हम लोग लाइन में रहकर उनके आनुगत्य में रहकर उन्हीं जैसा हम लोग की दृढ़ता से गुरु सेवा कर सकें और उन्हीं के समान हम लोग शुद्ध भक्ति का भी प्रचार कर सकें, इससे बढ़कर के मैं समझता हूं कि वो दूसरी सेवा से संतुष्ट नहीं। मैं यह कह करके अपनी श्रद्धांजलि उनके चरणों में दिए दर्ज करता हूं।
हमारे वो गुरुदेव हैं ऐसा। So, Maharaj Gurudev instructed him that he should stay with him. And very happily, Maharaj did it in his life. And he said that most of the time, he stayed with his Gurudev. So just after attending initiation, he went to Chichura with his Gurudev. And at that time, Puri Maharaj, as I could understand, he was Brahmachari at that time.
Paramanand. Sri Paramanand Brahmachari.
Sri Paramanand Brahmachari, he was in Chichura and he was giving lectures and doing so many services under the guidance of our Param Gurudev. Guru Maharaj, Gurudev, so he was doing everything under the guidance of Guru Maharaj, Gurudev, and Maharaj is saying that his Gurudev engaged him in service of Paramanand, what is his name? Paramanand Brahmachari. Pranabhananda Brahmachari. And at that time, he had very close association with him. He used to take him to Ganges to take bath. He used to take his clothes. Maharaj used to give him clothes and does cooking and all so many things. He was so much pleased with Gurudev that once he told that, "Would you like to be with me?" And Maharaj said that, he said, "Yes, I will, but I will take permission from my Gurudev." "Oh, no, 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 don't take permission from your Gurudev. I know that he will not give you permission. You are from such a high class of family. I want that you should always remain with me." So, Maharaj said that, again he said, "Okay, I will, but I will take permission from my Gurudev." And hence, this was a jestful moment. About 7 or 8 months, Maharaj stayed with him and they have very close association. Now, if we are celebrating separation, Maharaj is explaining what is viraha. It is a very important thing. In order to understand the mood of separation, the important thing is that when there is mamata, when there is very deep attachment, only separation can be realized then. Otherwise not. And when this mamata will come, when this intense attachment will come, only when we realize that we have been getting so much grace and so much upakar, benefit, but not benefit, upakar. Upakar is a very unique Hindi word, that we are getting the grace and benefit from that person, only we can have that intense attachment. If we don't realize that grace and benefit which we are getting, then we cannot have mood of separation. Without having such feeling, our separation will be only Maharaj was saying like Udhav. Udhav went to Gopis. Gopis are in a very deep mood of separation, but he was giving him Jnana. So our separation without having intense intimate relationship, intense attachment, it will be only external and it will come only on the principal level. Therefore, the important thing Maharaj is saying, and Pujpad Krishna Kripa Prabhu also has said, Brahmachari has also said on, in this regard, that Puri Maharaj was having very, very intimate and intense relationship with Param Gurudev. Why? Because he will never say him, Keshavji Maharaj, like this. Always he was saying, my Vinodda. So this mindness, which he was having for Param Gurudev, that was his love and affection. From the very beginning when he was living with Param Gurudev. Similarly, when we are attached to our Gurudev, our attachment is measured only on this way, when we realize that what we are getting from our Gurudev. Gurudev goes, we are feeling the mood of separation. Why? I have got a very big loss. What loss I have got? Oh, when I used to go to him, he used to give his all money and of his, which was lying beneath his pillow. Oh no, how I will get that money? So someone may have such type of separation. This is not the mode of separation. I was going to my Gurudev. My Gurudev gave me love for Radha Krishna. He showed me what is the real path of Rupanuga Bhakti. And he gave me intense love for Rupanuga Bhakti. Then I advanced in it. I attained something which is so high class of spiritual thing. And so I am indebted to my Gurudev. When I have this feeling and realization in my heart, when this will lead a sort of attachment with my Gurudev, that attachment is very real attachment. And that will lead to real mood of separation. Then Maharaj is saying, because he was so much attached to his Gurudev, that he was always telling him, Vinodda. So in all the prominent functions, and in most of the Vigraha Pratishtha especially, he used to be there. And Maharaj is also saying that when Vigraha Pratishtha of Vrindavan was taken place, at that time also he was here. And during the Kartik Parikrama, which Maharaj Gurudev used to conduct, most of the time he used to attend those Kartik Parikramas also. He was very generous. He was very liberal also. Maharaj is giving here a very practical example. He was that much liberal that whenever any person will go to him and ask for Harinam or Diksha, he used to become so much overwhelmed that without considering that how is this person, he will give him Harinam and initiation. Not only Harinam and initiation, even for if someone goes to take sannyas, He will not have much consideration about his standing and level. He will give him Harinam, sannyas very soon. Maharaj is giving an example. Oh, I have come from Vedanta Samiti. I want to take sannyas from you. Because I am also Brahman and you are also high class Brahman. So I want to take sannyas from a Brahman, Vaishnava. So please give me sannyas. Oh, yes. I will give. Someone may like it or not, but if we see from the point of view of Uttam class Bhagavat, it may be possible that they see that how this man will get benefit and they are giving something to him for his benefit. This is the generosity and benevolence of that Vaishnava. Maharaj is saying that when he wrote Jayabharam, he translated Jayabharam.
So many ISKCON leaders and so many ISKCON devotees,
they went to him for taking initiation. He did not even inquire whether you are initiated or not. He gave them initiation very, very generously. So, now Maharaj is remembering his own instances with him. He said that when he wrote Jayabharam under the instruction, translated Jayabharam under the instruction and guidance of his Gurudev, and he gave this
presented this
Jayabharam to Puri Maharaj. At that time he was overjoyed. He was so much happy, oh, you have done really a very good deed. He gave him plenty of ample of blessings, and he said that whenever you write any book in Hindi and translate any book in Hindi, please come and give to me. And Maharaj said that whenever he used to translate or write any book in Hindi and he used to give it, he was always welcome it and he used to give so many blessings.
और हम जब विदेश के जाते थे तो उनको उनका आदेश लेकर के जाते और आते थे फिर उनको जनाते थे और वो विदेश में हमको चिट्ठी देते थे और आशीर्वाद जनाते थे जो प्रभुपाद का ये विचार हमारा हजार बार
That I also remember, because Maharaj is saying that whenever he went to abroad for preaching, he used to go to him and have his blessings. And he used to give so many, plenty of blessings. Go and preach this principle of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu all over the world. And whenever Maharaj was abroad, engaged in preaching, he used to send letters to Maharaj. In those letters also he used to give so many blessings. Also, Maharaj is saying that only when he wrote life and autobiography of his Gurudev and in Hindi, and he presented to Puri Maharaj, he was very much happy. Oh, this is Hindi autobiography of my Vinoda. He read it and he said that this book is fantastic. There are so many autobiographies, but this autobiography has taken so many subtle points in it. It explains so many things that it is complete in itself. It does not only give the lifestyle of your Gurudev, but it gives his ideas, his thoughts, and it covers the whole Vaishnav doctrine in it. He was very happy that the way Maharaj wrote this Hindi biography, which has been not translated in English also. Maharaj said that when he met him sometime before in Jagannath Puri, he went to see him. At that time he was not so much sick. He was in his consciousness. When he went there, at that time he said, oh, have you written any other book in Hindi? The first question again. Is there any another Hindi book you have written?
And he remembered so many past times which occurred in Chula. I brought in Rota. मैं रोटा रहा था अपने लिए और कुछ नहीं कर रहा तो उनके साथ में गंगा स्नान करने गया इतने में ज्वार फाटा आया और वो रोटा भी कर दिया हमने कहा जो बहुत अच्छा हुआ हमारा एक स्मरण का था जो पास एक रोटा गया और कुछ तो पूरी महाराज जी से कहा पूरी महाराज जी जब उनसे मिलता था जरूर इसकी याद करते थे
As already told that when Maharaj was staying with him in Chichula for 6-7 months together and they used to go to take bath in Ganges together, Maharaj is saying that from his house. He gave up everything. He did not bring anything, no money, no any material possession at all.
Nothing.
Only one lota he brought from his house.
Water pot.
Water pot. Lota. By which we take bath. And once he was in Puri Maharaj, and taking bath in Ganges at that time.
Both
were taking bath together, and there was a very strong wave. A strong wave came in Ganges, and it took away that lota with it. When that lota was taken by Ganges, then
when he came, returned, I was touching my lota. Puri Maharaj began to smile and tell, "Oh, your lota has been taken by Ganges."
Then Maharaj said, "Then only one thing I brought from my house, and that is also been offered to Ganges." So Maharaj is saying that when he met him, I think a few months before or rather a year before, in Puri. So at that time, he was remembering that past time, that look, this happened with you. And now only, I think one month before Maharaj, again he was in Puri, and he went to Puri Maharaj in Jagannath Puri and saw him and paid his obeisances. Then Maharaj said he was very sick. He just opened his eyes, and by that opening his eyes he gave his blessing. So it is very important point that even Vaishnava never dies. Even no any living entity, soul never dies, how come Vaishnava will die? Maharaj is giving one of his idea here. He was being called by Radha Krishna long back. But somehow or other, his disciples, they tried to retain him here. They gave some obstruction for him going to Radha Krishna's eternal pastime. They were trying to keep him with themselves.
Forcefully.
That is why his life was prolonged for some time. Maharaj said that it is not good. We should not do like this. He is asking and floating a question to us that someone is just going to enter into the eternal pastime Radha Krishna. He is just going to participate on those in those pastime, and if you stop him going, how will he feel? What is the factual position? Therefore we should not try to give any obstruction to a person who is readily going into the pastime of Radha Krishna.
किसी भी शिष्य के लिए, किसी भी भक्त के लिए, साधक के लिए, उसकी गुरु निष्ठा भक्ति की ऋण है। हमारे गुरु जी का जब जीवन चरित्र उन्होंने देखा, ये प्रभुपाद की सेवा के लिए सर्वस्व न्यौछावर करने वाले हैं। अपने प्राणों को भी हथेली में लेकर के हमारे गुरु जी चलते हैं। उन्होंने नवदीप के पुलिया ग्राम वासियों का अत्याचार देखा और उस समय गुरु महाराज जी की सेवा देखा और अब जहां प्रभुपाद का कोई तरीक सा विरोध किया उसके लिए सिंह विक्रम से उसका प्रतिवाद किया जो कि और किसी भी गौड़ीय मठ के लोगों ने नहीं किया। यह सब देख करके पक्ष लोग गुरु जी के यहां बिक जाए। जैसे हमारे परम पूज्यपाद भक्ति शरण गोस्वामी महाराज इसी गुण के लिए गुरु जी को पाखंड गले का सिंह और अपना बंधु महाराज हमारे पूज्यपाद नरहरि प्रभु प्रभुपाद के काम से गुरु महाराज जी के पास अपने को बेच दिया। निशिंह महाराज जी और सबको देखा उसी प्रकार से एक परमानंद ब्रह्मचारी की कहिए या प्रारंभ से गुरु महाराज जी की गुरु निष्ठा देकर उनके प्रति अपने पुण्य उछाव
यदि गुरु किसी शिष्य में अपने गुरु के प्रति ऐसी निष्ठा नहीं है तो भजन दान में नहीं प्रवेश करता। यदि कोई गुरु महाराज की थोड़ी भी सेवा करता है तो उसके लिए सेवक उसके चरणों में अपना सर्वस्व विकृत कर देगा। और ये गुरु का के शिष्य का ये प्रधान इच्छा है। प्रारंभ से ही गुरु महाराज ने अपने गुरु जी की सेवा के लिए सब कुछ ने उठा। इन्होंने कभी भी कोई प्रश्न या शंका उनके जीवन में नहीं और संपूर्ण रूप से उनकी सेवा करने की चेष्टा की। प्रभुपाद ने उनको कोई आदेश न देने पर भी वो समझ जाते थे कि ये हमारे गुरु जी चाहते हैं, बस संपूर्ण रूप से उसमें लग जाते। या काम छोटा है या बड़ा है या कोई विचार कुछ नहीं, यही तो गुरु भक्तों का लक्षण है। इन्होंने देखा कि गुरु महाराज जी हमारे विनोदगार हमारे प्रभुपाद की अंतरंग और दूसरी सेवाओं में अंतरंग सब प्रकार की सेवा में ये पूर्ण दक्ष और समर्थन है, इसलिए उनको उनके कारण करते हैं। इसी तरह से हम लोगों को भी इसे शिक्षा लेनी चाहिए। देखो ये गुरु ठीक है कि नहीं, अपने गुरुदेव के मार्ग पर चलता है कि नहीं, हमारी परंपरा के लाइन में चलता है कि नहीं, तब तो बस उसके लिए संपूर्ण रूप से संभव। उस समय ये विचार नहीं करना है जैसे हम क्या करेंगे, उसके लिए जब संपूर्ण रूप से हमारे पति प्रमोद पूरी गोस्वामी महाराज हमारे गुरु जी की तरह देखो कैसे अपने गुरु जी की सेवा की, आदर्श सेवा पूरे इत्यादि के साथ। इसीलिए ये इस समय प्रचार कर रहे हैं। सब लोग ऋणी गुरु महाराज कहते हैं जो कोई सेवा नहीं कर सका वो हम प्रभुपाद की सेवा के लिए हमको कहना कहने की जरूरत नहीं होती थी, स्वयं वो करते थे। जिसे समझते थे गुरु महाराज ही इस काम से प्रसन्न होंगे तो लाठी पकड़ के भी चलते थे। बहुत से ऐसे मठ प्रभुपाद जी के हुए जो दखल किया गया जैसे स्वर्ग गर्ज का भक्ति ठाकुर का दो चार लाठी वालों को लेकर के लाठी बजा दी और बस वहां से भाग गए। वो कौन ललिता प्रसाद और प्रभुपाद सुन करके बड़े प्रसन्न हुए। ये सब है बिना विचार का गुरु जी की सेवा करनी चाहिए, तब तो वो भजन राज में प्रवेश कर सकता है। हम लोग जो कुछ भी कर रहे हैं हम जानते हैं कि हम लोग त्रिवि से भी कर रहे हैं, कोई योग्यता नहीं पढ़ा लिख रहा है तो थ्री क्लास के कोई भी योग्यता नहीं, बोलने की योग्यता नहीं, और तभी ये जो कुछ हम लोग कर रहे हैं और सभी हम भाई लोग सभी ये गुरु जी की कृपा है और कोई कारण नहीं। जो हम लोग अभी तक थोड़े के दान समेत जीवित है, इन लोगों का त्याग कभी भी कुछ नहीं चाह, उस त्याग के लिए हम लोगों को कभी बचे। तो यदि भाई तुम लोग भजन करना चाहते हो विद्या बुद्धि बल के पद का भरोसा छोड़ करके गुरु जी के विकृत पशु विचार नहीं करना है ये कैसे, तब तक फिर वर्षी महाराज जाएंगे बस वहीं तक स्तब्ध हो जाएंगे। और यदि सचमुच में परमार्थ चाहते हो, महाप्रभु नित्यानंद की कृपा चाहते हो, रूप गोस्वामी की कृपा चाहते हो, तो कृपा को प्रधान रख करके चलो, विचार बुद्धि को छोड़ करके अपना जैसे कि गोपीनाथ ये सब विचार लेकर के हम चलेंगे परमार्थ में तो भजन में हम प्रवेश कर सकेंगे। नहीं तो बहुत से बुद्धिमान हम लोगों से कोटि कोटि गुण बुद्धिमान हमारे राष्ट्रपति प्रधानमंत्री इत्यादि देखो तो कितने कितने बड़े बड़े विद्वान है। अभी हम लोग के पिछले जो राष्ट्रपति राधा कृष्णन और वो थे अभी तो बड़े दार्शनिक और बहुत तत्वों को जानने वाले, किंतु क्या भविष्य गुरु अनुगत नहीं है, उसमें विचार और कुछ नहीं करना है, बस एकदम उन्होंने कहा और शब्द में टूट गए। ये सब विचार होने चाहिए। गुरु महाराज जी हम लोगों को जो आदेश देते थे हम लोगों ने कभी विचार नहीं किया, बस टूट पड़े बस। और ये बहुत सी बात है, हम लोग अपना भजन करें और गुरु जी के आदेशों को गुरु के प्रति ऐसी निष्ठा हो जैसे इनकी निष्ठा हो तो हम लोग कुछ सीख सकते हैं, कुछ भजन राज्य में कभी
आज मन शिक्षा के पहले श्लोक को वो स्वमंत्र में और हरिनाम के प्रति रति को हमने बतलाया, उसका साधारण संक्षेप रूप में बतला रहा हूं। भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर जी इस उपदेश का सार बतला रहे हैं कि जब तक भक्त के संग के प्रभाव से कर्म वासना क्षीण नहीं होती, भजन राज्य में सबसे प्रधान चीज है साधु संग, वो भी स्वजातीय आशय स्निग्ध अपने से उन्नत तत्त्वज्ञ रसी वैष्णव, उनके संग से ही शुद्ध भक्ति हो सकती है, अन्यथा नहीं। अपने प्रयास ना करो नहीं होगा, नहीं हो सकता, ये गारंटी है। इसलिए हमारे रूप गोस्वामी ने सब लोगों ने कहा कि ये भक्त प्रसाद अथवा भगवत प्रसाद है भक्ति, विशेष करके ये रागानुगा पार अपने प्रयास से भी नहीं, वही भक्ति भी नहीं। इसलिए ऐसे भक्तों के संग के प्रभाव से कर्म वासना जब तक क्षीण नहीं होती तब तक शुद्ध परमार्थ की श्रद्धा उन्नीत नहीं होती। परमार्थ की जो श्रद्धा है ये उच्च कोटि के वैष्णव के संग से ही संभव है, अन्यथा नहीं। जब तक दृढ़ विश्वास की श्रद्धा नहीं उत्पन्न हो जाती तब तक हरि कथा और सदुपदेश श्रवण और ग्रहण की योग्यता भी नहीं होती। जब तक कि वैसी श्रद्धा नहीं होगी तो लाभ उन्नत कथा हो, प्रभावशाली हरि कथा हो, तो भी उसमें धारण नहीं कर सकता और ना तो छोड़ नहीं सकता। जब तक कि वैसी श्रद्धा नहीं हो, विश्वास नहीं होगा, लाभ चेष्टा करो नहीं होगा। यहां तक कि साधारण की तो बात क्या, ये काम भी निडर हो ये नहीं, झूठ बोलने की आदत भी नहीं जा सकती, कोई भी कुछ हम नहीं कर सकते। इसलिए साधु संघ में श्रवण और उनके उपदेशों की ग्रहण करने की योग्यता भी नहीं आती, सुनेंगे नहीं सुनेंगे, रुचि नहीं होगी सुनने, पालन ही नहीं कर सकते। सौभाग्यवश यदि परमार्थ की श्रद्धा उत्पन्न हो गई तो पहले दीक्षा गुरु के शरणागत होकर, पहले दीक्षा गुरु के शरणागत होकर विषमय न गुरु सेवा, क्या चाहते हैं विषम सेवा, लौकिक संबंध मत गुरु की सेवा करो, ये भी होना सहज नहीं है, गाय सहज नहीं। तभी कहते हैं कि ये भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर जी इसका सार लेकर के कह रहे हैं, दीक्षा गुरु के शरणागत होकर के भी शिक्षा गुरु की सेवा करते हुए जुगल मंत्र ग्रहण करो, दीक्षा गुरु से जुगल दशाक्षर नाम है अष्टादशा काम कर और ये समंत्रों को ग्रहण, मंत्र लेकर के दीक्षा गुरु शिक्षा गुरुओं की आत्मरति के द्वारा पूजा करो, हृदय के आंतरिक श्रद्धा से अनुराग से संपूर्ण रूप से सर्वांग भावेना उनकी सेवा करो। गुरुदेव को मैं मठ में आया उसके पहले कुछ बात विक्रम महाराज जी, उसके भी पहले कुछ बात बामन महाराज जी, बड़े कठोर थे, बड़ो कठोर शासक थे, हम भी जब आए तब तक तो थे, किंतु हमने उन कठोर शासक के रूप में मैंने कभी अनुभव नहीं किया। मैं तो एक तरह निकट में जाकर कम से तर्क वितर्क सब कुछ करता था और अपने पिछले जीवन में कैसे हो गए, जब पर्यटक इत्यादि आए तो वो पहले वाले संपूर्ण रूप से बदल गए थे, जैसे मथुरा के कृष्ण और ब्रज के कृष्ण में अंतर है, एक ही तत्व है, किंतु ब्रज के जो कृष्ण है वो कैसे हैं और मथुरा वाले कैसे हैं। तो गुरु महाराज जी का पहले मथुरा का भाव और पीछे अंत में अपने जीवन में देखा, जो छोटे छोटे बच्चे भी ये सब गुरु महाराज जी के पदम पर बैठ करके उनकी पद सेवा करते हैं, उनकी तरस तरह सेवा करते, उसे ऐसे लगे हुए मुख लगे हो गए थे कुछ बात, विक्रम महाराज जी को यह सब देखने का शायद सौभाग्य नहीं, ये अंत में कैसे वो बदल गए। इसलिए उनके प्रारंभिक जो जीवन की कठोरता है, भागवत कोई मत पढ़े, उन्होंने सुना, वेदांत
वे वेदांत महाराज जी से पढ़ना चाहते हैं गुरु जी से, और उनका कठोरपन जो पहले का गुरु जी का था वो सब इन्होंने लक्ष्य किया होते, और हम लोग जब आए तो बाग के जैसे बच्चे हो जाते हैं छोटे छोटे, और बच्चे उसके पीठ पर पेट में छत्ते से उनको पकड़ कर नोच भी लेते हैं। गुरु महाराज जी का जीवन ऐसे अंत में पलट गया था, उसकी कल्पना पहले वाले आदमी नहीं कर सकते जो पहले गुरु महाराज जी कहते। हमने सुना है दसवें स्कंद भागवत क्यों लोग पढ़ते हैं, एकादश स्कंद क्यों नहीं पढ़ते? हमने वो देखा नहीं, दीपिका महाराज जी ने देखा, हमने देखा ही। तो ये सब उनकी का जीवन चरित्र याद आता है। जब पीछा अंत में कैसे हो गए थे, तो ऐसे विषम पूर्वक यदि सेवा और कोई कर सके गुरु की, तब तो गुरु जी को प्रसन्न कर सकता है। फिर वही कहते हैं भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर जी कह रहे हैं इसका सार तात्पर्य क्या, साधु अपने गुरु और दीक्षा गुरु उनके प्रति ऐसी ही भावना, ऐसी सेवा, ऐसे उनके लौकिक सर बंधु बल हमारे परम हित ऐसी परम बंधु, तब तो सेवा कर सकता है, नहीं कैसे कर सकता। प्रभुपाद जी गुरु महाराज जी को डोकला और बोका जहाज, बोका नहीं बोका जहाज, कभी भी दूसरों को ऐसा गाली नहीं दिया, और गुरु महाराज जी सुन करके परम तृप्त हो जाते, कभी हमारे प्रति इतना स्नेह बरसता है, और यदि दूसरा कोई होता तो कभी गुरु जी हम आके बोका जहाज बोले, अरे ऐसा छोड़ दी चले जाओ। आजकल गुरुराज चेला देके कुतुरुक में तबाह करे, कर्ण तक मुझे उठते पड़ेगा। आजकल गुरु जी को अधिक चिंता होती है अपने शिष्यों के लिए, दिन रात यही चिंता करते कि हमारा ये शिष्य चला रहा है, ये हमारे यहां से एक महाचिंता आजकल गुरुदेव गुरुदेव महा प्रॉब्लम ही क्या जीवन कि हम इस शिष्य के किलो को माथे रखे आशीष की करे कोई लोग आजकल कलिका हमारा जन कलिकाले शिष्य गुरु ना कही ऐसा बोली विचार करे ऐसा भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर विचारधारा मंदिर के पीते हुए बोल चाहिए। देखो एक महते गुरु देवेश सेवा करते शिक्षा गुरु आर दीक्षा प्राणे बंधु जानिया लौकिक शब्द बंधु बतवे आर की सेवा करवे विषम में न गुरु सेवा एक जगह बोले विषम सेवा तारे को सेवा जे करे तारे का ডাইরেক্টে পশিনা ধুন্দ পারবে সেখানে আমার কোটি কোটি প্রাণ কেন উৎসাহ করবে, এরকম তো শিষ্য হবে তাহলে তো পরমার্থিক তার মধ্যে আসবে না, তা আসবে কোথায়? রাধা মুকুন্দ পদ সম্ভব কর্ম বিন্দু নির্মঞ্চন উপর লক্ষ্য দিয়ে কুতম সহ বসাত বিশেষ প্রকল্পাম দেবী গুণেশু ললিতাম ললিতা যাহা কৃষ্ণকে আর রাধা জিকে पसीने के बुंद जहां पड़ते हैं अपना कोटि कोटि प्राणों को न्यौछावर कर देती है, और इस सेवा से बड़ी प्रकल्प है, प्रकल्प मैंने कहा राधा और कृष्ण को शासन कर किस लिए इस प्रेम से। कभी कभी शिष्य भी अपने गुरु को इसी तरह से शासन करके करता है, किस लिए उन्हीं की सेवा के लिए, इतना प्रकल्प हो जाता है ये गुरु जी की सेवा के लिए कि वो लौकिक सब बंधुवत देकर के उसकी सेवा करता है, उसमें भूल जाता है कि हमारे गुरु जी कृष्ण के बड़े प्रियतम तत्व ज्ञानी और ये सेवा की करता ही है, और वो क्या करता है कि कनिष्ठ मध्यम उत्तम इन तीनों वैष्णव का यथाजुग सम्मान और प्रीतिपूर्वक सेवा सत्कार करना चाहिए। ऐसे क्या त्रिवेद वैष्णव उनकी योग्यता के अनुसार अनुसार यथाजुग सम्मान दो और प्रीतिपूर्वक उनका सेवा करो, साथ ही और भी गुरु प्रदत्त मंत्र गुरु जी ने जो मंत्र दिया है ऐसा नहीं कि बड़ी उतावली में हम करें कब खत्म हो जाए, कोई आ गया मिले और गुरु जी का कृष्णाय कर रहे
और फिर बोलते संजय जी आदमी आ गया क्लीन कृष्ण आया और भूल गया और फिर उससे बातचीत करने लगा। फिर इसके बाद में हाथ में पैसा रखा जिसका और इसके बाद में फिर जब चला गया तो उसकी बात सोच रहा है क्लीन कृष्ण आए स्वाहा। ऐसे मंत्र नहीं होता, हम लोगों का अधिकांश लोगों का ऐसा होता है। अरे सात्विक में सोचो कि वो राधा कृष्ण जी बने मंत्र एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ राधा एंड कृष्ण कंजुगल एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ गौरचंद्र नित्यानंद गुरु जी हो विद एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ लव एंड अफेक्शन विद सर्विस ऑफ कृष्णा एंड कृष्ण हो। ऐसा समझ करके भाई निर्विघ्न होकर के अचंचल चित्त से चंचल चित्त मत करो। उस समय में सब कुछ भूल जाओ और भूल करके सोचे हम राधा कृष्ण की सेवा कर रहे हैं महाप्रभु की सेवा कर रहे हैं सीधा बैठ करके तब फिर करो। और हरि नाम में अनुराग रखना चाहिए, अनुराग के साथ में भगवान का नाम करो इधर उधर ये देखकर अंततः तो कुछ समय ऐसा निकालो निश्चिंत रूप में निर्जन रूप में हम कुछ भगवान का भजन करें। गुरु जी का अनुगत वैष्णव का अनुगत रहेगा तभी तो उसमें से सेवा से कुछ अवकाश लेकर के प्रीति पूर्वक में भगवान का नाम हम करें। किस तरह से हरे कृष्ण हरे राम ये कौन है राधा कृष्ण ऐसा समझ करके जो मैं उनकी पद सेवा कर रहा ऐसा समझ करके उस समय विचार करके देखो गुरु कहते तो उस समय यदि कोई बुलाए अथवा कहे गुरुजनों को छोड़ करके तब फिर मत करो मत छोड़ो निर्विघ्न होकर के निश्चिंत होकर के जिनको करो राधा कृष्ण जुगल को भी अपना प्राण समझो और उनके चरणों में शरणागत होकर के भजन करो साधन करो तब तो भाई साधन में सिद्धि होगी अंधता सिद्धि नहीं। यही हमारे मन शिक्षा के प्रथम श्लोक का यह सार है। आप लोग अब हम लोग का आज ही समाप्त होगा ये कार्तिक महीना, कल हम इसका विधिवत समापन करेंगे यज्ञ इत्यादि होंगे किंतु इसका मूल चीज ये है इसका सार हम लोग जो अभी तक एक महीने में हम लोग विभिन्न वैष्णवों ने हरि भजन के लिए शिक्षा दी है जिस निष्ठा के लिए शिक्षा दी है उस निष्ठा के साथ में हम लोग हरि भजन का साधन करें जिससे कि हमको कोई भी प्रॉब्लम ना हो कोई भी क्या प्रॉब्लम समस्या कोई चिंता ना रहे प्राण को हथेली में लेकर के गुरु वैष्णव की सेवा के लिए चले कोई चिंता नहीं मरना को है जीवात्मा अजर अमर है साधन सिद्धि नहीं क्या होता है मंत्र साधन ना है शरीर पतन ऐसा लेकर के और यही सब चीजों को लेकर के लौटो। गुरु जी यदि शासन करते हैं वैष्णव लोग शासन करते हैं मारते भी हैं तो समझो कि हमारे लिए परम पावन है कभी उनके प्रति ये ऐसी भावना ना आए जो हमको शासन करते हैं उनके शासन को स्वीकार करो और चलो। किसी कारण से उन्होंने कुछ यदि अपमान भी कर दिया है उसको समझो ये अमृत है तब तो भजन राज्य में प्रवेश करेंगे अन्य आज एक करके मैं अपना इस समय का अध्यापक और तब समाप्त करता हूं। शाम को हमारे क्लास में वैष्णव लोग भक्ति कैसे होगी उनका अपना अपना शुद्ध विचार कि हम लोग कैसे भक्ति में प्रवेश कर सकेंगे इस सब पर हम लोग सब वैष्णव लोग वहां पर क्लास में प्रवचन करेंगे और हम लोग यही सब चीजों को लेकर के घर लौटे यही वेरी गुड इन दिस इवनिंग फ्रॉम 6:30 राइट दे आर गोइंग टू शो यू अ ड्रामा विद वेरी बिग ऑफ द
हरे कृष्ण गुरु निष्ठा इज बैक बोन्स ऑफ भक्ति रियलम महाराज हैज रिपीटेड हिज सेंटेंस ऑफ यस्टरडे important thing. Why Param Guruji was considered and honored by so many of his god brothers? Maharaj is giving a very, very excellent explanation in this regard. His Gurudev was having such a intense nishtha for his Gurudev, Srila Prabhupada. He served him by his whole life and soul. This was his main characteristic. This was seen by his god brothers. Maharaj is saying, the way he used to serve his Gurudev, without caring for his life, he used to take any uphill and any dangerous task. He would put his life at stake, but he will serve his Gurudev. For anything he sees that if his Gurudev is pleased, he will do that thing. That was the high class of quality of our Gurudev's Gurudev. This characteristic is such a high class of characteristic. This quality has put him in such a situation that his own god brothers, like Maharaj is saying, Narhari Maharaj, Narsingh Maharaj, they all sold themselves at the lotus feet of Gurudev because they saw that how much Guru Nishth he was. Maharaj is giving one example that once the mutt at Saurav Ganj, where Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to live, that was taken over by his brother Lalita Prasad.
And Prabhupada wanted that was
and Prabhupada wanted
anyone who can take this
back.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur Samadhi and Bhajan Astari. And Lalita Prasad should go away from here. So anyone is here that can do.
So he wanted that he should take over the charge of that Samadhi of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, which was taken over by his brother, because his brother was not in proper manner looking after it. He was not in line. So he wanted to take over, and he wondered if there is anyone who can do this thing, and no one came forward. Gurudev said,
if you like, I can, in a moment. Sir.
Then Gurudev said, but Gurudev of Maharaj said, no matter, I don't mind. And he went there, and Maharaj is saying, lathi bajai. He just had
a talk with so many
person
with a lathi, paska, lathi
bajai. He hired,
began to work themselves.
He hired some very robust person with big bamboos and lathi, and he went there, and they
said, where is Lalita Prasad? We will see. At once we will.
They were throwing the sticks on the ground, and they were fighting with each other. Where is Lalita Prasad? We'll see him. And the moment he saw Lalita Prasad ran away, he vacated the place, and the place was again recaptured by Param Gurudev.
Prabhupada became very happy.
So these were his services. The services in which he never cared for himself, his life, anything. He cared only for one thing, how my Gurudev will be pleased. This was an important point. Therefore, Puri Maharaj, who was also loving him so much, he was also rendering his service like his Gurudev. Why? Because he saw this Guru Nishtha in him. And similarly, Puri Maharaj is explaining that he also showed the similar Guru Nishtha. He never asked why any instruction or any services given by Srila Prabhupada to him, he rendered without any question. He never thought it is good or bad. This should be the attitude of disciple. Maharaj is saying, we see in ourselves, in our God brothers, we are living a in a very united manner. Why? Because of our attitude to render service to our Gurudev. Maharaj is giving his own example that he knows nothing. Look at his humbleness. He has got no qualifications, but only, he had only one thing in his life, how to serve his Gurudev. His dedicated attitude to serve his Gurudev, he said, it has led to this position that the whole world is listening in. There are so many intelligent people, there are so many highly qualified people, they came and went away. They had no any respect in the world. Like our President Radha Krishna, he used to be a very big philosopher. But what went to him? What became his fate? Finished. Why? Because they did not have dedication for their Gurudev. Whether they had Gurudev or not, that's also not clear. So, whole progress, whole success and advancement lies in this fact that how much one is dedicated to his Gurudev. One should, if Gurudev says, jump, one should not say the second word, why? And he should jump into the ocean. This should be the attitude of disciple. Without considering good or bad, like Kuresh. Maharaj is giving example, like Kuresh, disciple of Ramanujacharya. This was the quality of Param Gurudev. That is why he was being respected by his own God brothers. Now let us come to the point, Manashiksha. पर ये आपने मेरे के लिए मन शिक्षा में बताया महाराज जी मन शिक्षा के ही मन शिक्षा के अंतर्गत में बताया श्रील भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर इज गिविंग हिज कमेंट्री दैट हाउ शुड वी रिसाइट अवर मंत्र इन दिस रिगार्ड अवर गुरु मंत्र एंड महामंत्र ही इज सेइंग Very important point here we have to notice. Only with the help of association of advanced devotees, we will deteriorate and diminish and then finally finish our tendency of karma. Propensity of karma. Propensity of doing, performing action in this material world. Maharaj is saying, we are so far having propensity to get entangled into material world. Getting entangled into material world is called propensity of doing karma. And if we try to check ourselves, we try to remove this habit of our own efforts, it will not be successful at all. Only with the help of, with the influence of and mercy of high class of Vaishnava, we can come out of this very, very difficult propensity of our attitude. By our efforts, it will not do. Therefore, this bhakti, and especially Raganuga bhakti, is called a bhakti prasadat or bhagavat prasadat. Means, it is a result of mercy of devotee or Lord. Moreover, it is the result of mercy of bhakti. When our karma vasana, our lust to involve in this material world, our desire to get intention in material world, will, unless it goes away, we cannot generate a paramarthik shraddha. Paramarthik shraddha means when we get a faith in our heart towards our Gurudev that he is leading us in Krishna consciousness. When we have this firm faith for our Gurudev, that is called paramarthik shraddha. This shraddha, this faith will not come unless we are attached to the activities of material world. And this attachment will go only with the mercy of Sadhu Sant. Before that, we will not even have any taste to listen Harikatha. We will not like to listen. There will be no Shravan, even if we are listening, sitting in the assembly, take it granted we are not listening. Nothing will go inside. We have not received the mercy of Vaishnava and Gurudev. We have not come, we have not destroyed our attitude in this material world. We cannot listen well, we cannot do Shravan, and what to speak of retaining it in our heart. So, there are so many things in us, like lust. It will not go. We will not give up the habit of telling a lie. And all these things will not let us. Progress in Krishna consciousness. So after taking initiation, we have to serve our Gurudev like Laukik Satvantuvat. Considering him as our dearest and nearest most. Lokik Sad Bandhu Vat means, I would like to use here one word in English, kith and kin. Which means that he is so like our human-like relationship in this world. And we should serve him with Atmarati. Maharaj is using the word with Atmarati. What does it mean by Atmarati? Atmarati means with the core of our heart, we should serve our Gurudev. Then only we will be able to serve Radha Krishna conjugally. Maharaj is saying that when he joined his mutt in 1946, till that time his Gurudev was very strict administrator. And before that, when Pujipad Srivikram Maharaj was there, and before that even Pujipad Vaman Maharaj was there, he was very, very, very strict administrator. So when Maharaj joined, still at that time he was a strict administrator, but Maharaj said that he never himself felt that strictness in his life. He said he was very, very open and frank and very close to his Gurudev. He used to do so many arguments with him fearlessly. And Gurudev used to inspire him and enthuse him to do so, and will always give, his Gurudev used to give very inspiration to him to have such arguments, and he used to clear all those doubts and arguments. But when, like Pujipad Paryatak Maharaj and others came, by that time, his Gurudev became very much soft-hearted. Very much soft-hearted. His strictness was no more there. So Maharaj is giving very good example. Just as a tigress, when she has small kids, cubs, what do they do? Sometimes they will sit on her back, sometimes they will fight with her, sometimes they will ride on her neck and face. But what tigress does? Nothing. She loves Radha. So similarly, Param Gurudev, he became so much soft that on his cot, Maharaj was saying, all these young, very children like his disciple used to sit with him on his cot. He used to sit, sir, sitting on the same cot. He was very soft. No fear in the heart of any disciple. And they were very, very childlike, young disciples. So this was the different, totally changed attitude. Maharaj in here saying to Srila Pujipad Trivikram Maharaj that because he saw his that phase of life when he was very much strict, and he used to give very strict instructions, no one will read 10 canto at all. So these were the instructions during those times. No one will take the name of Srimati Radhika. But
or anything.
Anything.
And but that is why he is affected and he is now still.
And Maharaj is saying that he came on the later portion of his life when he became so much liberal and so much merciful and so much benevolent, and he gave all these things liberally to him and to others who came later on. So, so everyone here,
when it became Maharaj was there, when for he saw Krishna like Vedanta Tattvavi, and we. When he came and we realized that he is the Rashi of Bhakti.
So everyone here, all brahmacharis were saying, Maharaj, the similar is with you also. When old person they join Maharaj, they become their disciples, they found Maharaj was very strict administrator. But now when we have joined him, we find, oh, Maharaj is very soft, very lenient, very liberal. With no fear, fearlessly we approach him without any. And still when we talk to the old person, those who have to face the very strict administration of Maharaj, they still feel like they still are scared by coming close to Maharaj. Then, okay, but thoda tha, 2 minutes. We should chant the mantra given by our Gurudev with dedicated and concentration, not in hurriedly. It should be very, it should be considered that it is embodiment form of the its predominant deity. It is not only the world jugglery or world combination. So when we chant these mantras without any restlessness in our mind, in our heart, and with a fixed heart, then with a straight back, we should recite this mantra. Then Maharaj is saying we should recite Harinam also with great love and anurag. At least from our services we should take out some time that sitting isolatedly in a very solitary place we should chant our Hari mantra and should consider that Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, who are they? They are Radha Krishna and in their villas mood performing their pastime. So today our Urja Vrat is completed. Today is the last day. And tomorrow we will officially perform the ceremony of its completion. So whatever we have learned from Vaishnava here, we will take back to our house with a great dedication. So Maharaj is saying that how should we chant this mantra in this regard? Whether my body stays or does not stay, even if I have to leave my body, but I will chant this mantra with dedication. Maharaj also gave one example for Guru Nishtha, that even if a small drop of perspiration is seen by his disciple on his Gurudev, he should be ready to give up his, sacrifice his millions of life to get that drop dried. Similarly, Lalita Sakhi, when she sees a single drop of sweat on Radha and Krishna, she tries to wipe it off by her millions of lives. Her so much intense love and dedication for Radha Krishna has made her Parikrama. Means she has become so much strict and frank that she can chastise Radha and Krishna also. Similarly, those disciples who serve their Gurudev with so much of their heart and intensity, they also become so close to their Gurudev that while rendering their service, they become very frank. They may sometimes become furious on their Gurudev only in order to render their service. So, This is all what Maharaj said. With all Premanande.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Prabhupada, Sri Bhaktivedanta Maharaji, he said that we have got the golden opportunity to do the Vraja Parikrama with the highest Vaishnavas in different places of Sridham Vrindavan. We are staying in different places. And we have got the different opportunity to live in the earth and listen in the transcendental pastime of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But we should be justified that we have listened the transcendental pastime of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But how kind of benefit we have get in this society and associates? But those who are bonded soul, those who are falling or bonded primary stage, we cannot realize, but we have no authority and power that how kind of benefit we have got with associate the highest positions. But Maharaji said that if we want to realize that, so we should follow that autumn Sri Krishna Namadi Navabhavit Gracham Indriyami Shemanmukhi Jivadu Shayam Eva Sprathada. He explained that by this material energy or by this organ, we are not able to achieve this transcendental knowledge or feelings, the transcendental perspectives of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, how we can be achieve and realize? Atam Sri Krishna Namadi Navabhavikrachan Indriyoi Shevan Mukhe Jivado Sharam Evos Pratada. Shevan Mukhe, by the mood of service, this servicing mood. But this burning cells and this primary stage, how they can be get this mood? Then Maharaj explained that if we want to get or accept this mood, that submissive mood to the superior Vaishnava, but how we can get and how we can accept? Then Maharaj explained that Bhakti Parishanubhav, he quoted one verse, that he explained, give example, like that when we are hungry, then we take the food. After taking food, we can realize and we can satisfy, and we can, by the feeling, we can be satisfied that how I satisfy after taking the food. Like that, those who are surrendering to the superior or highest of pure Vaishnavas, by their mercy, if when he will be engaged practically in devotional service, by the mood of service in mood, then he will be able or he will be qualified to realize that kinds of claims. So, Atma Sri Krishna Namadi Navabhavit Gracham Indriyoi Shevan Mukhi Jivado Shayam Eva Sprathada. When he will be surrendered, then Maharaj quoted this another verse, another that is Guru Devatma. That Guru Devatma, that is by the surrendering of the lotus feet of the bona fide spiritual master. He explained that without the mercy of the bona fide spiritual master, nobody can be achieved or no can be proceed his life to the performing his eternal bhajan or transcendental bhajan. So, Maharaji, he explained mainly that anywhere, that one proof they say that anywhere that you will not be perfect, but you must be surrendered to the highest and qualified and bona fide who is come to this line, this bona fide and this disabled succession. So that in the last, Maharaj explained that verse. Bhayam Divyavesham, Devasham Shai. Why we are afraid in this world? Always we are afraid because we are attached to material things. For this we are afraid because these things are destroyable. Those who are attached to these destroyable things, always they have some fear because it will be destroyed once in time. For this, we are always afraid through these things because we want to satisfy them, we want to get the actual peace through these material things. But it is not possible. It is impossible, absurd. For this, until we will not be give up or remove these material things of this harassment from our mind or from our this mentality, until this we cannot be satisfied and we cannot be appeared or we cannot come to this platform. So, in last finishing, Maharaji explained that all these things in conclusion, if anyone want to satisfy in his human life and he want to perfect his life, so he must be surrendered in a bona fide spiritual master. Only the Guru and Krishna, they have the power, they have the ability, they can put this divine couple in the heart of the disciple. So, if anyone unconditionally surrendered to the lotus feet and always submissive to the Guru and Krishna, then by their boundless mercy, he will be perfect and successful in his human life and he will be get the golden opportunity to service the divine couple under guidance of this Guru and Krishna. Panchakar Bhutani Vashkasi Pashu Sukhavata Pratidana Tavan Kisaya Vashkari Kibamavata.
Dependent on bhakti.
If it is so, Hence, we should observe bhakti. If karma is not independent, if gain is not independent, if job not independent, independence is not dependent. So, we should observe bhakti. We should not give importance of karma. Sangha-siddha, bhakti, etc. are not so important. They also find. Our Guru Vaishnava suggested to live in Vrajadham with Vaishnava and observe Damodar Bhattu. No one should take Vrindavan and Navadvip, Pralaya to Gaya, Kashi and Swar. Because the forgotten are not parallel to Dhamma, where Supreme Lord take birds and first times hell. Dhamma itself is transcendental. It enhances unalloyed bhakti and devotion, including, say, I do pray to Guru as he told to pray the mercy of his Gurudev and implore his mercy so that Maharaj can continue the circumambulation of Vrajadham as he is doing now. If we forgive and abandon things subversive to interest of bhakti card and take the things that is suitable for bhakti, the things he abides, it will be helpful for the devotees and it is not always harmful simultaneously to abide. So, Goswami showed the degrees of those Shraddha, Tathashtha, the first, it all. And he also showed that many Pujaniya Vaishnavas has spoken about Shuddha Bhakti, Adhishra Chakra Bhakti, etc. So two kinds of Shraddha, Swami and Balapatna Shraddha. We should inculcate unalloyed bhakti, so that bhakti lata, about basic as we told in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, it will be easier to achieve. They told that bhajan are two kinds. Anishchita bhajan and nishchita bhajan. After taking initiation, if the devotees, disciples, fail to follow and listen to Sri Gopala, nor if he become able to go through what Sri Rupa Goswami told about, spoke about. This kind of bhajan is
on his Gita.
And
what?
On his Gita.
What?
After taking initiation, if the disciple, the devotee,
Bangla,
Jasopur Janta Sravan Kirtan Sadhishnange Asar Pad Sadhishnange Asar Pad Jasopur Janta Seva Nishtha Nam Nishtha Itadhi
Can you? What he told? What he told you to yesterday?
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. He explained that about the devotion, Maharaji advised to Krishna Kripa Prabhu that he would give some idea about the devotion. So, Krishna Kripa Prabhu said that what is devotion and how we can enter into the devotional kingdom. Then he said that that is karma and yoga, they are dependent on this bhakti. Nishtha means Anishtita means that we are not attracted and enthusiast and with the attraction do not worship to the lotus feet of Gurudev and the divine couple. That is Anishtita. And when he takes the shelter to the lotus feet of Gurudev and with the attachment, that is affection, and by the relationship, and he is practicing the Anishtita bhajan.
Bhagavad-gita, bhakti-bhaiti,
वो निश्चितार्थ जैसे एक दीपक है, दीपक को जला दो, तेल भी कम है और इधर से आंधी आए या थोड़ी सी हवा आए तो धोखे में क्या होगा? ऐसे ऐसे लम बताएगी या फिर पूछ सकती है। यह है अनिश्चितता। और जब स्थिर रूप से गिरने लगे कभी कभी उसमें हवा आती है तब वो निश्चितता। विशेष जानने के लिए उन ग्रंथों का आते कार्य संवेषण When or when has so many difficulties, problems, and we are doing bhajan, then it is called anishchita. But most of our offenses, most of our unwanted things have gone away. And now our intelligence has some part. Not going here. Then it is called nishtha. And after nishtha, then ruchi and then asakti, he has explained very well. So we should call. Ab samay ho raha hai, rangmanch par Guru Goswami ka din prarambh hoga. Main sankshep mein do teen baatein भैया की भक्ति में भक्ति राज्य में प्रारंभ शक्ति बहुत अधिक होती है। अब कहां चलेंगे?
जनांजन सभाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रील महाराज एक्सप्लेन जस्ट नाउ वी आर एंडेवरिंग टू गेट मर्सी ऑफ भगवान, इन अदर हैंड भगवान ऑल्सो ट्राई टू बेस्ट हिज मर्सी ऑन अस। Bhagavan is eager, more eager, how I can help them to take my Bhagavan is more eager, how I can help them to bring my abode. It's mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatamritam, composed by Srimad Goswami. In Srimad Bhagavatam also, in other scriptures, all sadhakas, they are trying to get mercy of Bhagavan. But in only pure Bhagavatam and Srimad Bhagavatam, we have seen Bhagavan is more eager to bestow his mercy and want to help his devotees.
Always searching. Oh, how fair
Krishna is always searching, where is cows, where is calves, where is sakas. At any means, at any cost, if we take Harinam, there is a result also. Srila Maharaj gives example. Once upon a time, when Paramudev was in this planet, he has got brother named Narahari Prabhu. He was so sick, even he could not digest water also. So Paramudev took him his previous village, that means Purvasram, to an Ayurvedic doctor. Ayurvedic doctor suggest him that he have to arrange some pure cow ghee and have to make him drink every day. Paramudev told, how it is possible? Even he could not digest even a drop of water. How he can digest pure ghee? Ayurveda replied, don't worry, I know. He could not digest even water also. But if you take ghee every day, then it will come out of immediate, but somehow or other, some ghee must be in his intestine, then his intestine will be more and more powerful. Then he can digest water and everything gradually. So it happens also same thing. So after next time, when Paranuja took him to the very eye doctor again, then eye doctor told his all patient, wait a little, I have to visit them at first. So I have to do my Paramatma at first. So he talked with Param Gurudev and Nalamani Prabhu. So Param Gurudev advised him so many things. And Param Gurudev told him so many powerful Harikatha. As soon as Param Gurudev finished his Harikatha, and they come out, after a couple of minutes, he expired. After that, he never see any patient. So what will be the result of this? It will go in vain? No. Never it will go in vain. Because Param Gurudev and Narayan Prabhu, they are pure devotee and they are disciple of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarvathakur Prabhupada. He took darshan and he have heard Harikatha from them. So he will get new birth in Vaishnava family and gradually advance in Krishna consciousness. Just like Srila Maharaj did. Another example. When you took birth, then all water go out. So, is that a result or not? After 10 bath, if you put even dust also, is that a result of bath or not? Must be there in the result of bath also. Similarly, if we take Harinam, be it sraddha or neglecting mood also, there must be some result. Because the name is so powerful. So, Srila Maharaj explained, come another point. No need to be hopeless in bhakti realm. But we have to repent for this, that, I have no bhakti at all. But not artificially. The more we advance in Krishna consciousness, this mood will come automatically. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, Prem dhan vina bhakta daritra jivan. Without the wealth of prem, my life is in vain. Srimati Radha Maharani, she comment, na premo gandhasti darabhi me haro, kandami surbhakta varam prakasitum, gongsi vilasana varo kanan vina, vivar vijat panapatanga kanan dikha. Oh, I have not even smell of bhakti, name smell of prem. Then if your son asks, why you are weeping so bitterly? Raja Thakurani is replying, if I weep bitterly, then everyone will praise me, oh, you are so great devotee. So Bhagavan Prakashitum, if I had or I have had bhakti for Vrajananda, without seeing his face, Bamsi Vilasavanalokanam Dina, who always play on flute, without seeing his beautiful face, how I can maintain my life? Just like there is a fish, he has love with the water. If you take out that fish from water, he will give up his life. But I have no love for Vrajananda. So without seeing his face, I continue my life. And other quotation of Srimad Radha Gurani, Purna Pulinda Purudaya Padabja Raga. Oh, that locust girl, they have such kind of brain, I have not such kind of brain. So they are more superior to me. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he quote again, Nayam Dharvasya Dharaya Padanam Kakaratul Dhyagira Kulami Nishitam Yokul Kodatava Namadhani Bhavishwati. Oh, when that day will come for me, when I utter a chant Krishna name, that tears will come automatically and hairs will reach out. Pullover and hair will be stand on my body. When that day will come? So, that many time at any cost, at any means if we take Harinam, there must be some result. Srila Maharaj give example of Vajrami. And if Maharaj for one slok, Madhura Madhura Metar Mangala Mangalana, Sakala Nigopalli Sat Phalam Chit Sarupam, Sakrivati Parigitam Sat Vyala Helayava, Rigupala Ramasvanta Ve Krishna Nama. So Krishna is so powerful. If we chant Krishna Nama with Shraddha, with regard, with respect, or neglecting mood, it is so powerful, it has some result and effect. So, one day, it will take to the abode of God, abode of Bhagavan. So, no need to hopeless in bhakti. What could a hospital, what thing, what could activity done by Jagai Madhai? Mahatma rescued them. So they never take Harinam with great regard, yet they get Krishna name, they get rescue, they Mahaprabhu deliver them. So how we can advance in Krishna consciousness? Srila Maharaj is doing conclusion. Don't give up good association and don't give up the sankara of name. So if ever you have in just like Vajrami, he had bad habits. Bad habits cannot easily second off. Yet, Vajrami, when he heard, when he uttered the name of Narayan, but not from Narayan. But yet, name is so powerful, Vajrami was so Durachar. Yet, Bhagavan delivered him, and after that he gave up his own home and went to Haridwar, and at last, same for messenger of Vaikunthas came to him and take him to abode of Bhagavan. So we should not give up Vaishnava Sangha and we should not give up the shelter of name. Then one day, that day must come for me, come for us, that God will send his messenger or his associates to take us to an abode. Hare Krishna.
Krishna, we must bestow his person. Gauru Pranam. I thought
that Purottam Prabhu and others will also speak, but no time. So you can speak, others can speak.
Hare Krishna. আমাদের শ্রী গৌরীদাম সমিতির বিভিন্ন শাখামঠ থেকে যে সমস্ত ব্রহ্মচারীগণ এসেছে
The most astonishing spectacle is taking place on the banks of the Tribeni at Prayag. Thousands of people are dancing, singing, laughing, and crying uncontrollably in ecstatic love. All have been driven mad